Well, guys, welcome back to Freak Fishing, and welcome back to the channel. We are down in Lough Derg, and as you know, I absolutely love fishing here. Last time I was down with Sen and Stanley, and nothing has changed. We're down here again with him, but hopefully it'll be a good day. I brought me perch stuff, I brought a few trout stuff, so I might even get the Holy Grail, the trio of the perch, trout, and pike, and we will see what comes across. So stay tuned. Now I'm about 2 hours 45 minutes drive away from the place, and I'm here before Senin, so we'll definitely give him a bit of grief about that. So let's see what today brings. So time to fish trout first, isn't that it?
Fingers crossed, yeah, after the trout first.
Where's my rod? I've the sticklebait twitch in natural. So I'm gonna cast this out now and we'll just see what we come across.
And we'll just cast her out. I'd imagine I'd like to let a good bit of line out, actually weed going by us now, so it could be the type of day that we could be reeling them in continuously and cleaning them off, but we'll just see what happens.
So let's hope. And we're kind of bouncing on the Tasmanian Devil. Is it Tasmanian Devil the full name?
Tassie Devil, yeah.
So we'll just see what we can get. It's early, so look at. Plan is we're going to go do the trout fishing, and then hopefully we're going to find some pike or perch. Going bananas. Ready? Haha, yes! Fish number one.
Good stuff, boss.
Blank, saved.
Nice trout, lad.
Trout on the sticklebait twitch. Beautiful, beautiful trout. That's the natural colour. I think them little orange markings make a big, big difference. Fish on.
Oh, he came off. That was a nice fish.
That's annoying. How hard was that? How hard was that?
It broke my heart down a little bit.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
And after that heartbreaking moment, we headed back out and trolled for quite long, and it wasn't long until the rod kicked off again. This time, this felt a lot heavier.
That felt a lot better. Although it's calmed down.
Yeah, sure does.
It's not a, I don't think it's a trout.
Go ahead.
What is that?
Big perch.
Huh?
It's big perch.
Woohoo!
Fish on.
Fish on!
Where's my net?
Where's the net?
As far away as possible.
Get a rod in it, dude. What is it? Wait, it's moving straight there.
Trout.
Huh?
Trout.
Moving straight there?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice, bro.
Go on, get him up. Yes!
Woo! Lovely fish.
This is an absolute beautiful, beautiful trout. Really, really nice. Something to actually eat, or try to eat it, or try to get at it. We were thinking of a pellet, but then we're thinking probably a cormorant actually. The fight on these is incredible from that big, big, big paddle tails on them. A lot of power. Let's just give her a bit of time. She's nearly already wanting to go.
That's what it wants to do.
So as you can imagine, this is a perfect way to start the tree species challenge, and with that we trolled around a bit longer, and then we noticed something funny. There was a new buoy in an area, and we just made sure that maybe there wasn't a net or something set up, so we went over to have a look. So luckily enough, it was only a new marker for whatever reason. We're not really sure why it was put down, but it's always better to be safe than sorry, and make sure no one's poaching.
This is the thing that's keeping me going for.
So with the monster in me, it was time to chase monsters of the lake with Jared the Pike. Now, we trolled up through the deep water, but didn't have much luck. Although we did find a massive amount of bait fish deep, deep down. In about 50 foot of water, we cast it down and they were sitting about 20 or 30 foot. And Senin was straight into one. But unfortunately, it was one of them days where the fish just kept on coming off the hooks.
Oh, the door's out. Lost him.
You're joking me.
Yeah, I lost him. Yeah, I lost him. He made absolute bits of it, look.
You're joking me.
You just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
So as you can see, it was a hard, hard day for Senin. But with the amount of hits he was getting on that rattle trout in the lemon colour, I decided I'd move on to that fairly quickly. But Senin made up for it and he really started bringing in the fish.
Senin is a fish on. Oh. Try and keep that down.
Yeah, we took it just under the surface.
Mmm.
While I was holding it as well. You hear the good smack.
What size is it? Nice size or is it?
It's hard to tell you.
Yeah.
He's making one out of shrimp.
Nice!
Ooh.
First pike.
Good stuff.
Of the day, obviously.
First pike ever.
Here, don't lose the lure of the net. The last time we were here. She's lively. Yeah.
Yeah, that's
a nice
one. Yes.
Nice pike.
Yeah. Lovely fish, guys. It's a lovely, lovely fish. I'd say he's maybe 80.
But yeah, something like that.
Nice hard cool. Fighting fish. We'll get released.
Yep.
Straight back down.
Yep.
Full of energy. Good stuff.
Brilliant.
Two species down.
Oh, another one on for Senin.
Pike number two, after missing a few as well. This one's actually in really nice condition. Lovely hard fish on the lemon rattle trout, casting into bait fish in about 50 foot of water. So let's get this guy released. Good stuff. Now, good stuff so far. We have the two species locked down. We'll see if we can get one or two more pike and then we'll go after the perch.
What we have is quite a nice fish on. Eventually, I think Senin is maybe 5 or 6 bites our fish in, if you add them all together.
This is much bigger, I think. My line's gonna cross that way. I'll try bring him around to the back. He's giving you some fight.
Yes. Very hard to know on this rod.
Nah,
I'm used to a heavier rod.
Nice fish.
I don't think it's that big. I really don't.
Really?
I really think it's that big.
Oh. Yes.
You!
Good stuff. That's some fish.
You have no idea how glad I am to see a nice pike. After we unhook them, we let them breed or relax for a few minutes. And this is what we have. Not massive, but certainly a welcome guest to the boat today. I was struggling for bites, couldn't get anything. And this is the first bite and the first fish I've got in terms of pike today. So 2 out of 3 down. Hopefully we get another nice perch. And then we're gonna have 3 very good of each one. Now, thank you for the visit.
Yeah, here she goes.
After losing someone to pike today.
So after another pike got off, we decided to change tactics slightly and troll and see what that might bring. So we decided we'd head for the perch, but not before trolling through the big bait ball of fish one more time.
Another fish on, guys, and it feels like a nice enough one again. Not sure how nice.
Oh, that's a nice fish, that.
It's a nice one.
Yes!
Ha ha!
Oh!
As I said, I wanted one more fish, and we got one more. This is down to the roach. As you know, I love this new colour, the chub roach. There we have our pike. What do we have? 87. Is that right? 87?
87, yeah.
Yep.
Slightly over.
Beautiful, beautiful pike. This was sitting right over a ball, or right in a ball of bait fish. There's a massive ball of bait fish here, and it's quite hard to pull the pike out of it because they're obviously looking at all the live roach, live hybrids, everything else. So what we needed to do is show them a big tasty lure, which was the line true roach.
Oh, straight down.
Straight down. We're going to move on to the perch, and hopefully we can find something along the similar standards of a nice looking perch.
And on the way to our perch spot, Senan decided he'd stop off in a little trout area and we'd fling a few trout lures to troll past just as we were doing it. And luckily enough, he was bang on the money.
Not bad. So putting this on for the drop shot, we're going to try some perch. It's the Kraft Day and Minnow. I find these really, really good. You actually put it on sideways, so I'll just show you what I mean. So there's me drop shot. Now I have this set up a little bit closer to the ground, just to see if they're closer to the ground, then I might move it up. But little in it that, and it just wobbles. Just see what we can find.
So after searching the deep for a while, we didn't really come across anything that was kind of gave us confidence to really drop the lures down and spend a bit of time. So we headed to a harbour, and it's quite deep, it's about 20 foot, and we found some fish.
Yes!
Three species complete.
Oh.
So with that, we were glad to get that last two perch. We weren't sure if we were going to actually do it, as the perch just seemed to have disappeared, and when we did find them, they weren't biting, but we did manage them. Perseverance paid off. And again, guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and don't forget to check out Senan's channel, which is Senan Stanley Fishing. He's always here in Loch Derg, and he does catch some pretty impressive fish, so be sure to head on over to his channel and check it out.